Good morning, class 5. How are you today? I hope you all are fit and fine, keeping home, keeping safe, taking all the precautions. Class, I'm Lalita, your English teacher. And today we are going to study a very interesting topic, that is our sentence. Why do we need sentences? Why do we need to talk? Can you stay quiet for a longer period, 1 day, 2 day? Or forever?
No.
Why? We need to express ourselves. And how do we express? If I speak French with you, will you be able to understand?
No.
For expressing our views, we need a language which is known to both the parties. For communication, we need a language. And communication starts with the language, and every language has alphabets. And alphabets join to form meaningful words. Meaningful words join in a particular combination to form sentences. How do we talk? We express each other with sentences. We tell our thoughts, our ideas. We read books. We read them all through sentences. There are words written. Words are all made of alphabets. And words join together to make sentences, right? So today we'll be learning about the sentence. What is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. So all of you open your English grammar book, page number 5. The sentence. Today we'll be doing the chapter The Sentence. When we speak, we use words and we need these words in sets or groups. The group of words should make a sense. We should be able to understand what is being said. And for this, punctuation also is required. Now read these group of words. Flying are the birds. Sky in the. Flying are the birds, sky in the. You may understand the general sense, but do you understand it properly? No. Why? Because these are not arranged in a particular order, the order in which they should be arranged. How a sentence is arranged? A sentence is arranged in such a way we understand the subject and the verb and object. A sentence may have subject or verb, but it may not have object. Object may be hidden. So, let's understand. Class, the teacher teaching is in. Do you understand this?
No, ma'am.
But if I rearrange it, the class teacher is teaching in the class. Do we understand?
Yes, ma'am.
What do we understand? That the teacher is teaching in the class. Or the birds are flying in the sky. Did we understand it previously? No. We understood there is an activity going on, flying. There are birds. But it was not properly arranged. To make our expression better, to communicate in an effective way, we should follow the grammar. We should follow the rules which are given in the grammar to make a sentence, to write a proper sentence. So, a sentence is the complete thought. A sentence has a meaning. A sentence always begins with the capital letter and a sentence ends in full stop, exclamatory mark, question mark. Let's take a few examples to understand more. Flying, the birds are in the sky. Can we make sense of this sentence?
No, ma'am.
But if you read this, the birds are flying in the sky. Can we understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
What do we understand? That the birds are flying in the sky. Right? Apples these sweet are. Do we understand?
No, ma'am.
We understand something about apples is being talked about, but we do not understand the sentence. If I say these apples are sweet, do we understand?
Yes, ma'am.
We are telling about the apples that they taste sweet, right? So, I would like you to read pages 5 and 6 and understand what is a sentence. Let's all discuss a few things about a sentence. A group of words that makes a complete sense is called a sentence. A sentence is a complete thought. A sentence in itself is complete. A sentence has a meaning. A sentence always begins with a capital letter. A sentence ends in full stop, interrogation mark, or exclamatory mark. Please read it and we'll do the rest in the next class. Thank you.